This is the wire for 2030 Zulu, February 21st, 2024. Precedence is routine. Information cutoff is 19:30. Bottom line up front. Government dissolved in Guinea. Red Sea attacks continue. Beginning with international events. In Guinea, yesterday, the ruling military junta dissolved the entire government, ordering all governmental ministers to surrender their passports. The borders of Guinea have also reportedly been closed as the ruling junta seeks to consolidate power. Analyst comment. Though no reason was provided for this change of stance, it is not entirely unexpected for a nation operating in a state of military coup for over 2 years. Guinea's main national contribution to the world is in the form of natural resources. Iron and bauxite ore are the main mineral exports, along with diamonds and gold. In the Red Sea Horn of Africa region, Houthi forces posted a video online last night strongly indicating that they have captured an American Rema 600 Autonomous Underwater Vehicle, or AUV, in the waters off the coast of Yemen. This underwater drone is reportedly one of the most sophisticated technologies developed for the U.S. Navy. In the southern Red Sea, Houthi attacks on commercial shipping remain constant. Overnight, one as-yet-unidentified vessel was targeted successfully with unknown munitions. The United Kingdom Maritime Trade Operations Center has issued a warning to commercial vessels, highlighting the threat of loitering munitions in the southern Red Sea. On the home front in the United States, the Biden regime has announced the cancellation of an additional $1.2 billion of student debt for approximately 153,000 people. To date, various federal entities have already canceled, or technically transferred to the American taxpayer, over $138 billion of student loan debt from approximately 3.9 million individuals. In New York, the revelation of a recent rule change has indicated that potentially tens of thousands of illegal immigrants have been allowed to receive substantial cash payments in addition to the monthly benefits already provided. This follows the announcement of $53 million in prepaid cards being issued to illegal immigrants in New York City, which includes payments of up to $10,000 per illegal immigrant without any accountability requirements or checking identity documents. Analyst comments for this wire. Though quietly passed last year, the New York Governor's Office changed the eligibility requirements for its Safety Net Assistance, or SNA, program to include illegal immigrants. Previously, this was a special welfare program specifically designed to provide cash payments to individuals who do not meet eligibility requirements for other programs. Though accountability is virtually non-existent, city officials estimate that approximately 10% of illegals living in New York City are receiving benefits through this program. As the total estimated number of illegals residing in New York City is approximately 173,000, this means that an estimated 17,300 illegals are receiving funding through this program. Though not surprising in the slightest, the overwhelming funding provided to illegal immigrants in New York has become staggering when compared to the average salary of taxpaying Americans. This concludes the wire for 2030 Zulu, February 21st, 2024.